The suggestion of Santa was real.
Okay, when I was 8 years old, my mother still insisted, I'm sorry kids, if there's any out there, you might have ruined something for some children out there because there's no kids, insisted that Santa Claus was real. And I said, Mom, all the kids at school are making fun of me, and I was like, he would be really old. So my mother whipped out the Bible and said Moses was really old. This is actually a true story. So then I was like, it's a true story. So anyway, she started telling me about how there's really, really old people back in the old days, and people who have a really good heart live really, really long. And that's why Santa Claus will live forever. And the spirit of Santa Claus was still real. Elves aren't necessarily real, but there are short people. And my mother made me feel a lot better because I told my friends my mom was crazy. Mom?
Yeah.
I was talking to Janice, and I tried to tell her that I think Santa Claus is real, and she said, no way. And the other kids in the class heard it, and they said, no way, Santa Claus is not real. And I was kind of sad, and I said, I know the Easter Bunny doesn't exist. That's a talking animal. But, I mean, Santa Claus, and I know Santa Claus doesn't exist, Mom. I don't want to hear it anymore. Everyone for years has told me Santa Claus exists.
Well, of course he exists, honey. Don't let those kids get you down. What on earth makes you think that Santa Claus does not exist?
Hundreds and thousands of years have gone by with this Santa Claus character. And St. Nicholas may have been real back in the day, but he would be really old, like dirt.
There's something else really old that I find very valuable. Good source of information. You see this? Look at this. Look at this right here. Who's that? Who's that?
Moses.
That's right. Was Moses the young man when he saved the world?
He didn't save the world.
Well, you know what I mean.
Freeze! Save my world.
Hundreds and hundreds of years.
Yeah, I mean, so he's a good guy, but there's lots of good guys. And just imagine if every good guy lived forever. That'd be, like, stupidly annoying with a lot of good guys.
Good people do live forever, and Santa Claus will live forever. And, you know, there is the spirit of Santa Claus, so even if the original St. Nicholas isn't around anymore, they kind of cycle through.
There's another old guy texting around their people's houses?
Guy, when one Santa Claus dies, a new one is reborn to become
what?
The true
That's,
Santa Claus.
This isn't the Antichrist. This is Santa Claus.
No. It's something evil. It's a natural form of life. It's the circle of the North Pole.
Why do they talk about little elves then? Because they don't. Santa, that
okay,
he's not going.
Well,
he doesn't need an elf.
The elves. That's kind of a mix up. You know, I mean, you know that nice man who works down at the donut shop?
Yeah.
It's not funny.
Ho, ho, ho!
Oh my God, you looked completely different a minute ago! You are the Doctor Who of Santas!
A second ago, I was just delivering toys to the children. But now I feel like I've just possessed a slacker sitting on his couch formerly 5 minutes ago.
Well, you were my dad, but now I guess you're something more. Santa, can I ask you a question?
You can ask while you sit on my lap.
No! Candy cane. Santa? Why are you such an anti-Semite?
So I never really had a chance to believe in Santa. I mean, that was dashed right at the start, you know? But my older sister, her name is Jill, and I heard this great story about when she was a kid and when she discovered that, you know, none of this stuff really existed. And so my dad was apparently sitting at the kitchen table one day, and this little girl walks up to him. His little girl walks up and goes, "What is this?" Holds out her hand, and he goes, "That's your tooth." And she just looks at him square in the eye and says, "Easter Bunny isn't real either, is he?" He goes, "No, honey. Santa Claus? Sorry." Just knowingly, really young age, just nods and goes, "I thought so."
To be in your head. It was
Dad,
right there.
Does this mean there's no Easter Bunny either?
Honey, Easter Bunny doesn't bring tea.
But if the Tooth Fairy's not going to give me money, is he? Is she poor like she was last year?
No, Easter Bunny's doing all right now that he's got a job. and a tooth fairy, they work together. No. The problem is that the tooth fairy was out late last night.
What about?
And when he got home, he completely forgot that there was a tooth under your pillow. And his head hurt a little. It still does.
So that's fine, because the pillow moved. There's a spot right here.
Oh, it scratched you. Yeah. So, okay.
So,
well,
what
here,
does this mean
see.
About
well,
Santa Claus?
I got a guitar pick. I don't have any money.
There's no Santa Claus, is there?
There's no Santa. Now, as long as we're at, there's no Santa, there's no Easter Bunny, there's no Great Pumpkin, there's no Moses, there's no...
Man, I gotta talk to you.
You still work at that bio lab, right?
Yeah.
You think I'm a good guy, right?
Yeah.
Will you help me achieve immortality? Good people with good hearts should live forever. I have a theory. With the right retroviruses, I can grant myself immortality, but the government would watch me if I ordered them.
Yeah.
So I thought if you ordered the retrovirus that I need to your bio lab, they'd blame the company and not me, and I can get it and I could be immortal.
I order white mice. For I think I have access to retroviruses?
Oh, I'll tell you what to order. I know where to order it. I'll go online and order it. Just use your name and your work address so it'll go to you. I'll share the fruits of my labor.
So I would be immortal too.
With me! Us together watching everyone else grow old and die.
Shouldn't use the nail file.
So, I'm offering you an opportunity.
Yeah, I...
How many times have you said to yourself, "I wish I were immortal"?
17.
I could make it happen. Just with some slightly dangerous biohazard materials in your office.
Do you have a list?
Yes, I checked it twice. And that's the extent of my Christmas knowledge.
And that's why Santa's an anti-Semite.
Oh, that's my voicemail message.
That's been on the whole time the government's been listening! Quick! Take this pill!
Switch to the government agency!
Oh my god, what a buffoon! Are you listening?
This man drinking it every time he mentions retrovirus, we do a shot of tequila.
No problem!
Never!
Back to the office! Swaller, swaller, cyanide. It's a Skittles. If I could get cyanide, I could get a retrovirus. So I'm just supposed to pretend it's cyanide? And pretend to be dead?
You don't deserve immortality.
Oh, I don't. Apparently not. Someone who deserved immortality would have a good enough heart to take the Skittle and die. At least try to choke on it. Taste the rainbow.
I don't know who is ever going to buy these 3-year-old Skittles.
Hi. Do you buy comics here?
Yeah, we do. Okay. I'm not the comic guy, but yeah.
Well, I have these old issues of the Phantom.
Okay.
That was subtler than I thought.
Because he keeps coming back with a different Phantom.
She doesn't know anything about comics.
Oh, the comics.
She's gonna rip you off.
Oh man. I've been buying these and reading them for years.
And where has that gotten you?
All right, tell you what. $1 and I'll throw in the Skittles.
Are there blue ones?
Yeah, new flavor. See?
Oh,
are
sweet.
Blue? Now with flavor. Blue and watermelon.
Wow. Brand new three, five years ago?
No, that's just...
Oh.
That's just to prove authenticity. That's not
totally
that
cool. Retro Skittles. Awesome.
Dude.
Okay, the buck and the Skittles.
Yeah.
All right. Okay. Give me $1. Because I gotta go over there and buy a beer.
Can I share a little secret with you guys? Something I like to talk about on stage, but I'm Jewish. Yeah, it's true.
No.
So I've been trying to fight it. I'm wearing red and green. But I don't have a lot of Christmas stories to share, but I actually do have one. I used to have this friend. He still exists probably. Well, maybe not. He was actually kind of old, but it's been years since I've seen him. Anyway, he was in his 70s and he worked with me. And Christmas season, he worked down at the mall over by the airport, the outlet mall where no one ever goes, as Santa. And so one time I happened to be over there because there are sales and I'm Jewish. And
freeze!
All these old idiots do not wish to imply that Jews are cheap and buy things only on sale. Only certain ones do.
Let them get.
So while I was there, I saw that Conrad was there as Santa. So I went over and said, Connie, I'm going to call my niece, Nina, who is also not Christian, but celebrates Christmas. Explain that one to me. So I said, Nina's going to come over. She's 5 years old. Her name's Nina, and she lives over in Durham. So I'm going to come over, take 5 minutes. Will you talk to her for me? He's like, no problem. So I go to the phone, pay phone, because it was a couple years ago, like 13, and call, no answer at their house. I was real bummed. Then I was in like the Saks outlet off Fifth Avenue, whatever it's called. And there was my sister-in-law and my niece, coincidentally, in the mall. So I grabbed her. I said, you know, Santa's here, and he wants to see you. And he's a friend of mine. So we can go past the line, because I got contacts like that. And she's 5 years old, very smart. And she's like, I don't think there's a Santa. I said, no, really. She goes, a real Santa wouldn't be here. I said, trust me. So I start walking her over to the line. Conrad sees me coming with her, jumps up almost literally, drops the kid that's on his lap, goes, I'll be right back, comes running over and goes, Nina! I haven't seen you since last year when you were sleeping in your bed in Durham. Amazing.
No typecasting in this theater.
I know that earring. Conrad!
Hey, Matthew!
Oh my god, they let you near children?
Yeah. Statue of Limitations runs out, dude.
That's awesome.
So, you're on your break. Cool.
Oh! What? Can you do me a favor? If I call my niece, my sister-in-law, and have her bring my niece over here, could you, act like you know her?
Oh, yeah, what's her name?
Nina.
Oh, okay.
Nina. Four letters. Okay, Nina, and she's...
Nina, Pinta, Maria, okay.
Yeah, like that. Okay, and Nina, she's 5 years old, she lives in Durham, and if you could, she's into barges
Durham?
And stuff.
She's not armed, is she?
She might be. Okay.
Nina, Durham.
So I'm going to go find a payphone and use a dime to call her.
You must work for a pharmaceutical company. You've got a dime.
Look, honey.
Yeah,
it's really pretty and shiny.
Hey!
Hi, Matthew.
What are the odds of you being here in the most expensive store in the mall?
Well, my husband's credit card.
Nina, do you want to see Santa?
There's no Santa.
No, Santa's here. He's a friend of mine. He's in the mall. He specifically wanted me to find you.
If Santa even is real, he wouldn't be wasting his time here.
Santa loves Marsville. No, come on, come with me, and I'll show you Santa. I'll bring her back eventually.
Go with Uncle Matthew.
Fine.
That's it.
Bye.
That's a long line.
Nina, I haven't seen you since last year at your house in Durham. No, restraining order! Restraining order!
Mom, where's the hose?
Oh, you're tripping!
I've rolled in, chemical biomatter to acquire superpowers.
Honey, you smell like... Oh my god, you smell like the bathroom after your father's been in there. Back up!
What's the septic tank?
Honey, you rolled in a septic tank?
To get superpowers!
Get out of the porch! Get out of the porch!
I want to be the next Santa Claus!
Okay, rolling in sewage equals Santa? Please explain.
It'll give me superpowers! Like for the X-Men.
Stay still! Get in the grass! You mean superpowers? So all this time you could have rolled in poop and you would have superpowers?
No! It has to happen on a...
Has to happen on what?
A full moon!
Turn around. A full moon. Oh, it happens to be a full moon. You're gonna be cold out here. Honey,
would be cold, but I'll be Santa Claus at midnight.
You'll be Santa Claus at midnight.
That's when the whole thing will take effect.
Are you on drugs, young man?
No.
I'm serious. Empty your pockets.
The mall Santa gave me candy canes.
The one in Morrisville? He's been in the paper! Into your pockets!
And he was smiling when he was in the paper.
Yeah, I know.
He had numbers in front of him.
Ew, I don't want to touch that.
Honey, if you become Santa Claus at midnight, I will buy you a Porsche with all the money you can steal from
me. If I become Santa Claus at midnight, I will give you a Porsche because my elves will build it!
Okay, so who's going to turn into the elf? Since you made a Santa Claus, who's going to turn into the elf?
How it works.
Is it a little too much depth for you?
Where's the bio stuff so I can be your elf?
Oh my god, right, Jimmy. Jimmy, don't listen.
Wait,
no, don't roll with it.
No,
it's cool.
It's
cool.
I'm going to call your mother.
All the toys you want, Jimmy, in the back.
I'm going to call your mother. If you invite one more neighborhood kid over here to roll in our poop, I'm going to be upset.
One more? What if it's three or four more?
Oh, honey, no. No.
Hey!
Debbie, backyard.
Right?
Backyard.
Oh, yes. Debbie!
I know!
Debbie!
Yes!
Honey!
Christmas every year from now on!
What's you having your face rolling poop?
I would like to apologize for the Roseville idiots who are not aware that within the comic book universe, Lobo killed Santa Claus 15 years ago. And so it would be irrelevant for me to get superpowers and be Santa Claus. Couldn't happen. Lobo killed him.
Look it up on Wikipedia.
And I would like to apologize for the audience's behalf for having to listen to that crap. Because we don't... Never
mind. And that's our show.
Thank you very much for coming out and listening. We thank you for supporting me and the Improv Comedy in particular. Once again, we are so happy to have you here tonight. And our next show is September 27th, Atomic Bombs, another A show.
Watch for that. You'll always know us. So, once again, your idiot player starting at the far end, the lovely Romney Rossi. Musical Uncle John Patel. The traveling Kate Patel. The mathematical Brian Piper. The kosher Matthew Cravat.
The Kate molesting Mikey West.
Good night.
He goes from Lobo's back, he goes to heaven and hell, and then he goes to Santa Claus.